Hi, I'm Phil Twyford, the MP for Te Atatū. This is a shortened version of a presentation I gave recently about getting a commuter ferry service for Te Atatū. It was at a public meeting, which, as you can see, was very well attended. The ferry is not a new idea. It's been around for a while, but I think it's one of the transport solutions that could work really well for our community. What have we got now? Well, very poor public transport. A motorway that gets jammed up at peak times with congestion spilling back into our neighbourhoods. We need better bus services, but I also think we should look at a commuter ferry service. You see, we've got this stunning harbourside setting. Why not capitalise on that? Would you rather sit in motorway traffic for 45 minutes with the sun in your eyes? Or sit back in a ferry and read the paper while you glide across the harbour on your way home? Auckland Transport are looking to expand ferry services. And here's a map showing the current and future possible services. It's Auckland's Blue Highway. In 1986, a study identified Te Atatū as a potential site for a ferry terminal. In 2005, consultants looked at 14 new services around the region, including Te Atatū. They shortlisted six and ranked Te Atatū as the fourth priority. Later on, the Auckland Transport Agency adopted a plan which identified three options for new ferries: Takapuna, Browns Bay, and Te Atatū. So as you can see, a lot of work has been done, but not much action. I'm talking about a direct commuter service. It's 11k and would take 30 to 35 minutes. It's almost the same distance in journey time as the successful West Harbour service, which is shown here by the purple line. Te Atatū is the red line. The West Harbour service has been running since 2006. It carries 300 passenger trips a day, 60,000 per year. It runs 14 trips a day between Mondays and Fridays. And during peak hour, there's a service about every 20 to 30 minutes. This is one of the West Harbour ferries. A one-way trip between West Harbour and the city costs $12 for an adult and $7.70 if you have a concession. Here is an artist's impression of the new wharf about to be built at Hobsonville Point. Hobsonville Point will eventually have 2,500 residents. It only has a few hundred right now. As well as West Harbour and Hobsonville Point, Beachhaven is about to get a new ferry wharf. There's even a ferry service to Rakino Island funded by Auckland Transport just for holidaymakers. All of the passenger ferry services are subsidised by Auckland Transport, except for Devonport and Waiheke, which are fully commercial. The consultants identified the Te Atatū South Boat Club as the most suitable venue for a Te Atatū service. It wouldn't require any dredging. It would only need a relatively minimal new pontoon at a cost of $3.2 million. The downside is that there is little parking available and only small ferries could get under the Faux River Bridge. It might be worth looking at the peninsula side of the motorway as a possible alternative. An access road from the motorway interchange beside the motorway leading to a park and ride area under the pylons. This would require more investment in the infrastructure, including building a wharf from scratch. The catchment area is one of the things that will determine whether a ferry is economic. West Harbour is the purple area in the map. It's got a catchment of 4,000 households within a 5-minute drive. If you include both the peninsula and Te Atatū South, you've got about 10,000 households. I reckon that's pretty good. What would it cost? Well, the consultants estimate $3.2 million for a new terminal and an annual operating subsidy of $350,000 a year. I reckon that's peanuts compared to the $25 million Auckland Transport is about to spend widening Te Atatū Road. Well, how do we make this happen? If we think it's a good idea, then let's make our voice heard. If you've got questions or things you'd like to say about the idea of a ferry service for Te Aroha, get in touch. Here are my contact details.